Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video, and today we are finally releasing the converter from cycles to octane. And before we jump into how to install it, also how to use it, I just want to warn you guys that this version is a beta version, so there is a lot of bugs yet, but the reason I'm releasing it is because a lot of people is asking for that, and also I know how important it is for the community. So this is another very strong argument to release it. So one important thing about this add-on is that when my company decides to create it, we are migrating from 3ds Max to Blender. Nowadays we are totally all set in Blender, so we are creating like the entire scenes we are creating right now. It's totally in Blender. We are not like using 3ds Max anymore. So this is definitely a big and huge victory for our company. But again, the reason we actually decided to create it were to convert 3ds Max models from 3ds Max to Blender. So with that said, what we thought at that time was, okay, how to convert the 3ds Max models to Blender? We needed at that time an add-on to or a script to do that for us. So then we found this 3D to all, and they have this Max to Blender add-on. So we are still using it because we still have like models from 3ds Max, and that one of the things I think you guys asked how I had like that many objects in my library in Blender, and this is one of the reasons we are like converting all our library from 3ds Max to Blender, and that's why we have like a huge library with more than 10,000 models. And then we started from this point. Okay, so we have right now this converter that is Max to Blender. Now we need to convert from cycles to octane, because this Max to Blender just convert objects from 3ds Max to Blender in cycles. So we had to convert from cycles to octane. So that's where Rodrigo came in. Rodrigo is one of our Python IT guy. He's responsible to create all the add-ons in Blender for our company. And he started developing this cycles to octane add-on at that time. So right now, it's actually very good to use if you are using this Max to Blender add-on. So again, we developed this cycles to octane add-on just to solve the problem we had with the Max to Blender add-on. So all these things are totally linked. So with that said, probably some models from other sources, like I don't know, iMesh website, I don't know, there are a lot of different libraries out there, but probably those libraries won't work very well. So I'm gonna test some models from iMesh. I'm gonna show you like some of the issues, but it's still much better than the one that Octane has by default. Okay, so let's get started. I'm gonna show you how to install it and also how to use it. So the first thing you have to do is go to the link that I left on the comments down below, and then download this add-on. You can just go here on the code button and then click on this download zip, and it's going to download this zip file over here. Then go to Blender, file, oops, edit, preference, then install, then downloads, and then select the zip that you just downloaded. So install addon, then turn on the cycles to octane converter, and basically that's it. Okay, so second thing, I'm gonna import one of the models that I converted from 3ds Max to Blender using the Max to Blender addon. Okay, and I'm gonna show you how good it is, how fast it is, and then I'm gonna show you models from iMesh and what you need to do. Okay, so I'm gonna just import these three over here. So let's take a look. Again, it's gonna, I don't know, if I think I have already told you about this library. It sometimes take a little longer to load because these libraries on the cloud, then it needs to be downloaded. So here it is. Here I have my tree. So this tree, again, comes with cycles nodes. Let me show you here. Here we go. Here it is. Okay. So we have like different channels, slots with different textures, right? Then if you press N and then go to Octane, now you're going to see that the Cycles to Octane tab is going to appear for you. And here you have like some options. And the first thing, you can convert object by active material, active object, or selected objects. I usually use the selected object, so I can select sometimes more than one object and then press convert materials node. All right, so let's try it out. I'm gonna convert from cycles to octane, so convert to octane and then press convert material nodes. So as you can see, now we have the tree already converted. So the first slot it's already set, and second one, so third one and fourth one. That this one's probably the leaves, so that's why it's a little bit more complex, but basically that's it. Another thing that I'm gonna do here, probably you don't need to do that because my library is from, it's coming from the cloud, so I need to relink the textures again. So I'm gonna relink it here on the tools, views, let me see, where is it here, texture relink. I'm gonna select my textures and then I'm gonna copy and paste the path here and relink all these textures. All right, so let's render it and see how it looks. And here we go. So as you can see, very easy to convert materials from cycles to Blender, especially when you are like using the same add-on I used before this step, that is Max to Blender. All right, so this is one big thing to keep in mind. Okay, so it's working very well if you are using Max to Blender add-on converting materials from 3ds Max. Okay, so let's try another one. I'm gonna delete this one. All right, so let's try this one here. This one looks very complex, so I'm gonna import it here we go. I'm gonna relink my textures, just a sec, and then we're gonna convert it. All right, so let's take a look on the materials. So a lot of materials, and let's select everything. Then I'm gonna go to the Octane convert material nodes, convert to Octane, then that's it. So let's render it. Here we go. So as you can see, it converted basically everything. So this for us looks awesome. So let's try out some models for iMesh. That's where the problem comes in. We're still working on it. Probably we'll release new version of this add-on in the next, I don't know, couple of months. But for now, that's what we have right now. But still, this is very helpful. So I downloaded some models from iMesh, and three models actually, that I'm gonna test it out over here. I'm gonna import the models here. So here we go. So here we have this bottle of, I don't know, bumblebee. All right, so let's take a look here. Cycles, then we have like this this materials over here, right? Let's try to convert it. So I'm gonna select everything here and then change to Octane on the render engine and convert to Octane. And let's try it out. So as you can see, it converted some of the materials, and some of the textures it didn't convert. And then we have to adjust it. So that's where the problem comes in. So we have to go, for example, in the red juice and change here the color of it. So red juice, and same here for the orange juice, change the color of it. So that's how you need to adjust it. Also, let's take a look here on the glass. Lots of nodes over here. Yeah, and probably you have to adjust roughness, something like this, to look like it still doesn't look like a glass, so I have to kill probably the amount here. Now it's looking like a glass. So this is the work you have to do. All right, so let's try another one. And probably you find out that some models you won't convert, because sometimes the artist that create the model, I don't know, for some reason create a lots of different nodes, and some of those nodes probably this converted won't understand what they are, and then it won't convert. Okay, so let's try this one here. Choose mesh. Right. Let's take a look on this one. Let's convert it. And let's see. Yeah, so this one is one of those problems that I just said. So probably here we have like to adjust a lot of stuffs. So as you can see, this node, this material looks very big, and you have like to work on it. All right, so let's see another one. Support on these apples. No, let's try this chair over here. Okay, here you go, convert. Okay, so this one a little better. So we have like the wood, the black wood over here. Probably you have like to work on the transform textures to adjust the size of it, but this is still good. All right, so let's see. I don't know, 5. I don't know, where is it? Okay, so here, wood. Let's try 1. Oh, this one here. Yeah, this one here, 0.5. I don't know, I have to like to tweak a little bit. But again, this can save a lot of time still. All right. So let's try the Apple one here. I download another one. All right, so let's convert it. All right, so let's see what's going on over here. So as you can see, for example, here, this RGB curves, Octane doesn't have it, so it probably won't work. All right, so let's unplug it. This one over here, color ramp, Octane doesn't have it, so it won't work. So this is the thing, all right? So for example, this is the texture, the main texture, and you have like to connect it here. So probably, okay, right now it's working. So this is the thing you have to pay attention, all right? So you still have like work to do, but you don't need to, again, relink everything. It's already there, you just need to tweak a little bit. I think the main thing about this add-on right now is if you are working, if you have a lot of 3ds Max models and you are converting it as well and want to convert it, this add-on is gonna help you a lot. By the way, again, we are still developing, still working on this add-on to work with objects in the iMesh store, also trees from, I don't know, Sketcher or Botanic, I don't know, things like that, but we won't have it like the next week, in the next week, probably again in a couple of months. All right, so that's it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed it and you like it. So if you like it, please subscribe to the channel. Also, leave your message down below. If you have any questions, I will be glad to answer. Okay, thank you guys, and see you in the next video.